Hi and welcome to my channel. Today I want to talk about productivity and things that I have been doing, particularly over the last few months, that has really helped me boost my productivity, particularly since having my little boy just under 15 months ago. I found that my time is even more limited and more precious than ever. I've made a real effort to make the most of my time, not waste as much time as I used to. I am a self-confessed queen of procrastination. Before having my little boy, I would put things off right to the last minute and then do them in some crazy mad panic. I don't have the luxury of being able to do that now I'm a mum. So it's really important to just use my time wisely and get as much done as I possibly can. So just to give you a little bit of background, my working week is that I work as a digital marketing manager Monday to Thursday, and then I have the rest of the week to concentrate on my other business and projects that I'm working on. So I really have been trying to do as much outside of my day job as possible because I have real goals that I want to achieve for both myself and my family, and I do think that having goals in mind just makes you so much more productive because you've got something that you're constantly working towards and you prioritize things in order to achieve those goals more quickly. So for those 4 days that I work as a marketing manager for a major sports brand, I am very conscious of wanting to get everything done at work that I need to get done during the day and then be able to do my own things in the evening. So after my day's done, I drive home from work and I pick up my little boy, and at that time I am all about playing with him, spending time with him. I give him his dinner, I give him his bath, and I love to cuddle him to sleep. And then once he is fast asleep, I then have a few hours to myself, and during that time I just want to be as productive as possible. So beforehand I would have just scrolled on my phone, looked on Instagram for ages, or had a little bit of a Netflix binge, but I've just decided now to move away from that and make use of that time. I like to do things such as getting outfits ready for me and the baby for the next day. It's one less job to do in the morning. I am up pretty early the next day, so the less I have to do in terms of preparation, the better. I also make lunch for the next day as well that I can take into work with me, and I can just literally grab that out of the fridge as I'm heading out of the door. I've got everything there and ready, and I don't have to worry about things. So after I've done those things and I've prepared dinner, I'll then have around about an hour to just sit down and work on my own projects and my own business. I try to do as much planning as possible so that everything that I do outside of work goes really smoothly, and when I'm in work I can just concentrate on what I'm doing. For the other days that I am not in my day job, I make sure that I get up at around about the same time that I would have done had I been getting up to go to work. I make sure that I get a shower, I get my hair done, I get my makeup done, because I just feel like if I'm dressed and I'm ready, I am far more productive for the rest of the day. Another thing that helps me is writing an achievable to-do list. I'll either do that at the start of my day, or even better, if I get a chance, I'll do it the night before just so I can hit the ground running. I like to put up to say 3 priority tasks that I want to get done that day rather than have an entire to-do list. I find that if I do that, I get overwhelmed. I end up running around like a headless chicken and I either half do things or end up just not doing the most important things. What I've started doing is having little time slots for each part of my day so that I know exactly how long I've got. It really focuses the mind and it just makes getting those tasks done so much easier. Also, I am quite a traditional girl. I have a diary. I like to write things down. If I've got any appointments, I just like to check it every single day and make sure that I am on track with everything and that I'm not forgetting things. This is my brand new diary for 2019. She's very gorgeous, and it just really helps me to organize myself. Obviously, you can just use your phone if you don't want to write things down or have the clutter of a diary, but I'm traditional, that's how I like to do things. Another little hack that I've implemented into my day to day is to make the most of my passive downtime. So times like when I drive into work and back from work, usually it takes around about 40 minutes. When I'm driving into work, I like to listen to the news, find out what's going on. I like to listen to new bands and new music. When I'm driving home from work or I'm driving to, say, my mum and dad's, I will always listen to motivational podcasts, or I'll listen to experts in the areas that I'm interested in, particularly in terms of marketing. I've got a few that I listen to regularly. They really do keep me up to date on new trends, especially in that area where things are just progressing and there's new platforms coming up every month. I just find that really interesting. It helps me in my day job, it helps me in my own projects as well. So that is just something that I really like to do. I like to listen to entrepreneurs and just find out what they are doing in their day-to-day lives that I can implement into mine too. I feel like every day I'm constantly learning something new, and that is time when ordinarily I would have just put a CD on and kind of zoned out. Instead, I like to make the most of that time as well, and it's time that I really enjoy. Also, listening to motivational podcasts I find really helps keep me on track with my goals. It keeps me focused, it keeps me enthusiastic. Obviously, I have downtime, particularly before I go to bed. Me and Chris will watch an episode of something, but we just don't binge watch it anymore. I think it's really important as well to get at least 7 hours sleep every night, because if I don't get that, I end up lying in or being groggy the next day or unmotivated because I'm tired. Sleep is a really, really important part. It keeps you rejuvenated, it keeps you fresh, and it keeps your mind active. So getting enough sleep, funnily enough, is something that keeps me productive. It stops me from having little afternoon siestas and keeps me working at the maximum level all the way through the day. I think the biggest hack for productivity is being accountable for every single minute of your day. Honestly, I was the worst for making excuses why I couldn't get something done. I just don't have those excuses. If I organise myself properly, then I really can achieve everything that I set out to do. And I really do have to keep telling myself that my goals are achievable if I just stay focused, keep myself organised. And I can't make excuses. I want to make the most of my family time, and I want to achieve my goals as well. And the only way to do that is to keep myself organized in these ways. So I hope that you've enjoyed watching this video. I hope that you've learned something new today. If you've got any hints and tips for me, then please feel free to leave them in the comments below. So thank you so much for watching. Please like this video if you've liked it, and subscribe, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye.